And certainly when we talk about automation, there is often an underlying concern about, is this going to mean our jobs are going to go away? The reality is jobs will evolve. Well, we're getting more and more digital natives coming into the workforce. And so automation that many people would have viewed with concern a few years ago is now being seen as inevitable by the digital natives coming into the workforce. With that, some of the skills that historically have been really valued, the hard skills, are becoming arguably less important. And the softer skills, the ability of people to really engage, build relationships, show empathy and compassion, to really pull teams together, make them highly productive, are going to be much more important. So people that spend the time on some of those softer skills are certainly going to be more successful in the future. I think we have to realize that change is hard, full stop, irrespective of what the change is. And if you go throughout history, you can look to see that change has generally had people fighting against it. If you go back to the agricultural revolution and the swing riots of the 1830s, or the Luddites who smashed all the machinery at the beginning of the industrial revolution, there's always people that are going to find the change threatening. The reality is jobs will evolve. They've always evolved. The jobs that the next generation or the generation has after that will look entirely different to the jobs we have today. But one needs to accept that the change is difficult, that some people can accept change relatively readily and others will take much more time to do it. So understanding what people's genuine concerns are rather than trying to push the process through. And often some of the work that we consider to be mundane is actually work that people enjoy doing. It's work that gives them some degree of purpose. So it's trying to understand how you balance those two things. And those kind of that ability to listen to people and really be empathetic to their situation is going to be important through the change process. The constant need to upskill the workforce is paramount. I think what's interesting is the way that companies are viewing learning and development is very different today to what it was 10, 20, 30 years ago. Increasingly, people are a lot more self-driven. The way that people are educating themselves is very different, and it's often not in a linear fashion. We all know there's moments when a colleague will say, "Oh, I've just watched a great TED talk, you ought to go and see it." And it may be something that has nothing to do with your role, but you pick up a small nugget of information or something that you can then relate to your role and your task. And so I think it's going to be more about people that have an ongoing curiosity for learning and willingness to develop and evolve are going to be successful. And that's what we need to provide for the employees, both here and elsewhere. At all points in one's career, you need to be curious. The person that asks the open question is willing to have their preconceptions challenged. We live in a world where confirmation bias is becoming increasingly prevalent. And it's hard sometimes to hear opinions that don't naturally coincide with what you believe. For people to be really successful, they need to open themselves up and be prepared to listen to new information, new data, change your minds, change your experience, look for ways to evolve in the world as opposed to just viewing that you have a single linear path. That kind of ability to think laterally and move laterally is going to be very important.